Hi, I'm Gideon King, founder of NovaMind, and in this video I'd like to help you to get started using NovaMind 5 for Windows. When you start up NovaMind, it'll look like this. At the top you have the ribbon bar with tabs for the different options, a Getting Started panel, and until you've entered your license key, you'll have the Trial ribbon on the left. Let's start with the Getting Started panel. When you click on the Introduction Video button, it'll allow you to watch videos to help you understand NovaMind 5 and get started using it quickly. When you click on the Welcome Mind Map, it will open a mind map that tells you about a lot of the features of NovaMind 5, as well as some of the important shortcut keys, so that's definitely worth a look. But for the moment, let's just get started with our first mind map. We make it really easy to get started because when NovaMind starts up, your first mind map is already created and the title selected, so all you need to do is start typing. Notice that even if you haven't closed the Getting Started panel, it'll be put away automatically when you start your mind map. But if you want to see it again at any time, you can access it through the Help menu. When you've put in your text, just press Enter to finish editing. To add a subtopic, press the Insert key. And to add a new topic as a sibling of the topic that you've got selected, press Enter. To add a sibling above the selected topic, press Shift Enter. When you add anything to a mind map, the colors, fonts, and styling of the object are defined by the theme that you're using at the time. If you want to change the overall look of the mind map, you can select a different theme. If you've changed any formatting to be different to what's used in the theme, then your custom formatting will be honored when you change themes. Wherever you see an option to reset the formatting to the default, it will remove the custom setting that you've applied and revert to whatever the theme defines for the selected item. If the theme doesn't define anything specific, then in many cases the option will be inherited from its parent topic. You can change the overall colouring of the mind map by selecting a different colour set. Any colours that are set using themed colours will be changed to their equivalent in the new colour set, ensuring that the colours still go well together and have the same relative intensity. You can alter the layout of the mind map by selecting a topic that you want to lay out the children of and choosing a layout option. Quite often you'll want to use the radial layout for the first level topics and linear layout for the subtopics, but it's up to you. The layout settings can be changed individually on any topic. You can set the angle that the subtopics are laid out at using the angle control. If you click on one of the quadrants, it will rotate the axes to be either vertical or horizontal in that direction, but if you want it to be laid out at another angle, just drag it to be at the angle that you want. In most cases, the automatic layout of the topics should be everything that you require, but occasionally you may want to move a topic into a specific location. To do this, just mouse over the topic and you'll see both the graft and move controls. To move the topic to another place, drag it using the move icon with the four arrows on it. To put it back to its automatically laid out position, use the reset location option. If you want to move all the subtopics of a topic back to their default locations, use the Arrange Subtopics option. You can use the automatic coloring to make your subtopics look good. Just select the option that you want, and any subtopics that don't have their coloring manually set will use the automatically calculated color. This allows you to make interesting-looking, colorful mind maps with a minimum of effort. You can style the shapes in different ways using the gallery of shape styles, which are generated based on the themed colors and other style settings. This is just a convenient means of setting a number of options all at once to give an aesthetically pleasing result. If you want to have finer grain control, you can use the settings for the fill and the line. We recommend that you do stick with the themed colors where possible, so that you can change to a different color set and still have the mind map look good. To make the topics more interesting, you can either drag on images from the File Explorer, or you can use the built-in media library. We do provide a huge number of images for you to use from within the NovaMind media library, and we'll be adding to the number of libraries available for download over time. But to get started, you should download the initial library. This contains over 3,000 images and is therefore quite a large file, and it'll probably take a few minutes to download. But once you've started the download, you can carry on your mind mapping while it completes the download and installs itself in the background. You'll see that there are two categories of images there: adornments and images. The adornments are special images that automatically go on the left end of the topic and are used as a visual indicator of a particular meaning. You can have as many adornments on a topic as you like. Just drag them on and you can drag them to reorder them. And to remove an adornment, just drag it off the topic. The images can be dragged onto topics and you can have up to 4 images on each topic. Just drag an image on and drop it in the quadrant you want. As you build your mind map, you're bound to need to graph topics from one place on the mind map to another. To do this, drag the topic by its graphed handle, and if you have multiple topics selected, they'll all be grafted in the graphed operation. The indicator will show you where the topics will be attached when you drop them, so you can easily see what the effect will be. If you want to create a copy of the topics instead of just moving them, you can hold the Control key down while you drag the topics. You also have cut, copy, and paste available if you prefer that method of working with your topics. You should be aware that if you're using the radial layout, there are topics on the left and the right-hand side of the parent topic, and if you just move a topic from one side to another, it'll be laid out as if it was on the side that it was attached to start with. So if you want to swap to the other side, you'll need to graft it from one side to another. This gives you a lot of flexibility in the way the subtopics are laid out in relation to their parents. You can resize your topics by dragging the resize handles. Once you've resized a topic, you'll see lock icons that indicate that you've locked their size and are not using the automatic sizing of the topic anymore. If you want to revert to automatic sizing, click the lock icon and it will go back to automatic sizing. Often you'll want to add more information than you would just have with the keywords on the topics, and this is done using the topic notes. You enter the notes by selecting a single topic on the map and displaying the notes sidebar panel. With this basic information, you have everything that you need to create your mind maps. But of course, there are a lot of powerful features and options that we haven't touched on at all in this overview. So for in-depth information on these topics, please see the detailed tutorial videos.